Hi everyone and welcome to Power Map. Geographic information, known also as geospatial data, is data in a table that identifies geographic location of a particular place somewhere on Earth. It could be cities, countries, roads, or oceans and rivers. Now, where is spatial data stored? Spatial data is first stored in latitude and longitude. It's specific information for a particular place on Earth. We can use them in a GPS or a power map. Spatial data can be also stored in zip or postal code format. They can be stored as place names like country, city, or state. Finally, spatial data is stored as street addresses. These are the types of data that you are looking for if you like to create a power map. The World Population 2018 is a workbook that includes a table with the country code, the country name, and the population of all countries in the world for 2018. Also, it has extra information, like the region for each country and the income group. So, we are going to use this table to create a quick power map. From Insert tab, I'm going to click 3D Maps and open 3D Maps. There is one type of spatial data that it can find right away, and it's the name of the countries. So, if you look at these dots in the map, they are the country names, Spain, France, Greece, United States, and so on. I can name this layer, if I wish, clicking the Edit button here. Name it World Population. Now I want to add population data to visualize in my map. If I go to Height and select Population, I can see in my map the population of each country. You will notice that some countries has very large population, for example China and India. If I point to this, I get the exact population number. If I prefer to see something other than a column chart, I can change the visualization to a bubble, and I get different size of bubbles based on the country population. Large dots for India, China, Pakistan, Indonesia, and so on. I can choose a heat map, which is different colors to different populations. As you can see on the scale here. Or finally, I can choose this region visualization with a scale from light to dark orange. Of course, if you want to change the color, you can do it from there, layer options. Let's select a red color. I can also adjust the opacity of the layer and the color scale. If you are not happy with the result, you can click this button, Reset Layer Colors. So those are the settings. Nice! Now let's add another layer. This is layer 2, with the same choice as layer 1. What I want to do is to add region as data field from category to visualize it. Let's spinning the globe here to be able to look at the new information, the population and the region of each country. This is how it works. These are the legends that you can remove them. When we choose File and Close, we are actually save this as part of Microsoft Excel workbook. So I'm going to close this and save the whole Excel workbook. Anytime you want to return to the map, simply click on the 3D map button and open the map. We have one tour we've been working on, and here is the map with our data. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to format the map. So let's dive in. First of all, these are a series of themes available from this button. Each one of them has a name, and you have to click to see the results. For example, aerial color or radiate. Let's return to our power map theme. If you want to be able to show details about the actual locations, then you will enable the map labels button, and you get the names of the countries, the borders for each one. And if you zoom in, you will notice the city names, lakes, rivers, mountains, and so on. You can also display a flat map. Let's click on this button, and you will notice that you get a smooth scroll in it. You can enter that you'd like to find a specific location from the Find Location button, and you can zoom there instantaneously. For example, if I want to go to Rhodes Island in Greece, it's where I live, I type the address in the box, and here I am. Let's zoom back out using these zoom tools and these arrows to spin or rotate the map. So, these are the primary ways to format the power map and set up exactly how the map appears to us. Let's delete the second layer we created from previous lesson. Now I'm going to click the category, add field and select region. Enable also the legend button. And you will notice what happens is that I get this legend with regions in different color, Europe in orange, North America in green, etc. If you look at the map, you will notice that the regions with the specific colors are applied for each country. So this is what a category does. It provides a breakdown of the information that you already present with a color coding. If you want to remove a category, simply click the X icon and it's gone. That's how we add categories in a power map. This is tour 1 that has one scene in it. Let's spin to United States and zoom a little. And we are going to add a new scene. Click the button New Scene. And it creates an exact copy of what we've made so far. Let's create another scene for Africa. Zoom in a bit and click again the New Scene button. Follow the same steps for Europe, Asia, and South America. Okay, the tour can have a name, so rename it to Regions, for example. And each scene can have a name also. To change the name of each scene, All you have to do is to click on the gear icon. There are some options here, like change the name of the scene, the duration, and the effect of the transition from one scene to another. The transition duration, it's better to be at least 3 seconds, because less seconds tend to bother people. Start from North America, change also the duration of the scene to 5 seconds, select an effect, for example this one, then Africa, Europe, Asia, and South America. If you want to remove a scene, all you have to do is to click this X icon. Nice! I think we are ready to play the tour. Click on the play button and the presentation has been started. So, this is how we add different scenes. In general, the scene takes a photo of the map we have already, and then we can make changes like name, duration, and transition effects. That's it for today's lesson. If you have any questions, please let me know. Bye!